to Brakehurst High School to our spring music in Motherwell. Delighted with the turnout tonight and looking forward to the various musical events. I'm sure you are as well. So without any further ado, I'll introduce our resident, I don't know what we can call Harry, a musician, principal teacher of music, orchestra leader and everything else, Harry Watson.
there's written quite a few pieces, but don't ask me any other than that one. Now, as usual tonight, lots of people taking part, so take your indulgence between items if you allow us to move things around a little bit. But it's my great pleasure now to introduce Mrs. Johnson and the junior choir. realise, ladies and gentlemen, I shouldn't have shifted this. Draw it back again. Now, our prize-winning adult choir, give them a hand on Mrs. Johnson. outstanding members of the music department. And they're trying to build up the clarinet group year by year, and I think that at least I believe they're doing that. So hand over to Mr. Lundberg and the clarinet.
Thank you.
happen at the next concert. But one of the requirements for higher music is the composition of an original work. And Lindsay Taylor in fifth year has composed a trio for three guitars, and I felt it was of such high quality that it should be featured in tonight's concert. So Lindsay Taylor and John O'Donnell, Lydon and Carol will perform Canción para Chitarra by Lindsay Taylor. Oh, after Alan Bell.
Thank you. Thank you.
Orchestra have their annual concert in Motherwell Civic Concert Hall on May the 28th, Friday night, and the central work in that concert will be Beethoven's Symphony No. 5, plus another selection of music to suit all tastes. 16th, 17th and 18th of June sees this year's annual production, which is Guys and Dolls. They've only started rehearsals late January, and we thought we'd try and put a wee bit of it together tonight just to give you a flavour of the story. It's a bit Damon Runyon, it's larger than life, it's all about gamblers and so on. And we're just going to try and give you a very short selection from Guys and Dolls. Still a long way to go, so bear with us, we'll just give you a taste of things to come. It starts with a fugue. You've heard about a fugue already tonight. This is a vocal fugue between Kenneth, Mark and Dan. You won't make out the words because they're all jumbled up. But it's clever stuff, this.
I got the horse right here. The name is Paul Revere. There's the guy that says if the weather's clear, can't do, can't do. This guy says the horse can't do. If he says the horse can't do, can't do, can't do.
A big Valentine, cause on the morning light, this guy says the horse can't die tonight.
But then he says the horse can't try it out.
Established river, then floating crab came in.
We know
there are well-heeled
the last item, I'm going to propose a vote of thanks. Harry and I were setting out the hall today discussing when the vote of thanks would take place, and he suggested the concert was better ending in a high, and therefore we should go on now. Thanks very much, Harry. Keep it as brief as I can. My wife's had me warned that it's 5 minutes I shall walk out, so I'll say a few words first of all about tonight itself. Can I thank first of all the ladies in the PTFA for the tea tonight, the programmes, the tickets, etc. The money raised in the raffle tonight was £92, and the tea £24. That's £116 to the PTFA fund. I mention that because this week, on Tuesday night, I was in the hall looking at these curtains with the ladies, and they suggested we needed new curtains, and I didn't disagree. I decided to spend £6,000 of PTFA money to buy new velvet curtains in the school colours. A great contribution from the PTFA, and as rector, I'm delighted to accept that kind of invitation. So we'll purchase our curtains, and the next time we'll be in here, we'll be really decked out in the school colours. But thanks very much to the ladies of the PTFA. One announcement for them, they're having a coffee morning and a nearly new sale on Saturday morning from 10 until 12 o'clock. Turning to the evening's concert itself, to the various items, I'm going to start tonight by mentioning a group that I missed out at last Music in Motherwell, so I'll start with them tonight. And really, they were tremendous, and that was our junior choir. I was really enthused by the energy they put into it. It's great seeing the older kids there in the school show at the end, but without a junior choir, we wouldn't have that at the upper school. So very well done to the junior choir and to Mrs. Johnson for all the effort you put in with her as well. Well done, junior choir. Can I thank next our orchestra? The Lanarshire Cecillian Orchestra come twice a year here with our concerts, Music Motherwell. They're our resident orchestra with Harry, and I must say, Harry, the quality tonight has been absolutely exceptional. Very, very well done, and a very big thanks to the Cecillian Orchestra. Can I ask you to stand, ladies and gentlemen, take a bow, please? Next to the amateurs behind me here, but really, what amateurs? Tonight, these young folk have excelled themselves, the school band. Well done to our school band. We've had quite a number of groups taking part in competitions recently, including our older members. I'll use my words carefully here, choose my words carefully. Our adult choir. They started off with 2 or 3 members a couple of years ago. Now over 50 members every Monday afternoon, and recently won a competition, Canvas Lang, so they went into foreign territory and won their very first competition against very strong opposition. So big thanks to them for entertaining us tonight. There's one member of that group that the adult choir would like to thank tonight, the person who is really behind it all, Christine Johnson. If you look at the split between boys and girls tonight, I think you'll agree it's mainly girls who have been entertaining us with their musical talents, but two boys are very brave tonight, and not only brave but very talented. Two soloists, Ian Crawford and Alan Fernand, I thought were tremendous. Well done, boys. To our very talented trio of Lindsay Taylor, Leslie Ann Carroll and John O'Donnell, again a very, very warm thanks to you girls. About the music department about 8:10 this morning. It's not unusual for me in the morning wandering about the building. It's nice without kids. And as I was wandering about the music department, I came across Lindsay Taylor. And I said to her, Lindsay, you must be pretty thick. And she said, what? I says, well, in here at this time in the morning, I'm to practice. Well, tonight, Lindsay, you proved me wrong. You're not very thick, you're brilliant. Well done. Got a book in my hand here. I read a lot. My wife will tell you I read a lot. She says I'm a snob for reading things like the Times Educational Supplement, educational books and management books. Got a book here tonight called The School Experience. It's by a former head teacher in another school down the road. I think it's near Copper Street or something like that. He's a man from Airdrie, a very famous man in the town of Motherwell and a famous man in the town of Airdrie, James K. Scobie. And I like this book and I like a lot of the stuff in it. And tonight I'm going to just quote a wee bit from his book. It's about extracurricular activities. I'm a great believer in what this man is saying about extracurricular activities. What we have to look at now are the activities carried out outside school hours, at intervals, in the evenings or on Saturdays, and usually organised by volunteers from the staff who have such enthusiasm for their activity that they are prepared to sacrifice much of their leisure time to promote it in the school. Participation by the pupils is, of course, entirely voluntary, and the proportion of pupils taking part in most schools probably varies between 20 and 60%, seldom more. For those who do take part, their participation will often provide the most memorable, if not the most productive, component of their school experience. I believe that, and I believe that we are doing that in Breakhurst in this day and age. Just as James K. Scobie was doing way back in Dale High School. Without teachers though, we couldn't do that. And the teachers in this school give up a great deal of their time. I had the idea about a month or so ago of trying to boost extracurricular by having medals, special Breakhurst medals, lovely medals here. And I was thinking, how could I launch this initiative? And I think the nicest way would be to give the two teachers tonight who are very special, Christine and Harry. Talented youngsters, and some of them who are not so young, with a tremendous range and quality. And can I thank you for coming along and adding your appreciation to that. And we'll finish now with a great orchestra, the Lanarshire Cecillian Orchestra, led by Harry Watson.